let's discuss a little bit of a different topic. I ask you a question. When you meet someone, what stands out about him more than anything? His character. How he acts. How he deals with one another. And likewise, we're going to be discussing right now the character of a Muslim. Well, this is a very, very deep topic, so I hope everybody's got a little bit of popcorn next to them and something to drink, because I don't want anybody going to the refrigerator during the next couple of minutes. We're going to discuss the character of a Muslim. Let's discuss the best of creation. The Prophet Muhammad, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, as the creator of the heavens, the universe, and all that exists, made mention that you are on an exalted standard of character. This is a statement in the Quran from Allah. And in another place in the Quran, it makes mention that verily in the messenger you have a good example to follow. Therefore, the Muslim tries to emulate and imitate the character of the best of creation, the Prophet Muhammad, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon him. Now, what does that entail, you might be asking? Well, I'll try to give you a little bit of an idea. Let's discuss right now about the character. Firstly, what does a Muslim not do? One of the major sins in Islam, to lie. It is not from the character of a Muslim to tell a lie. Because if someone tells a lie to you and you cannot believe him, that speaks out more about his character than anything you could possibly think of. Let's move on. What we call in Islam, birr walidain, or honoring one's parents. The Messenger of Allah, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, was asked one day, who has the most right to my good treatment? He said, your mother. He was asked again, who then? He said, your mother. He was asked for a third time, who then? And he, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, said, your mother. And he said, he was asked, and then who? And he said, your father. Now, if I was a mother, I would be jumping up and down right now. But I'm a father, and I'm still happy. Although I'm not jumping up and down, but I'm still happy. What does this mean? Islam calls upon the Muslim to honor one's parents. And in another place in the Quran, it makes mention not to say to them, uff. And this term of uff in Arabic means the following: to show that you are not pleased, discontent, or some type of disrespect to your parents. If your parent asks you to do something, then it is not for you to say anything. No back talk, no this, no that, but to honor your parents and to grant them that which they want. And if they reach old age, to take care of them, to give them any services you possibly could, and honor them to the best of your ability. As for the father, what a lofty status we have. Because in Islam, there is no one except for the mother who is more deserving of good treatment to us, and I'm a father, alhamdulillah, no one is deserving of good treatment more than me than my wife. But that's okay, she can have that status because Allah gave it to her. Another aspect of the character of a Muslim is that he is gentle. The Prophet, the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, stated, verily, Allah is gentle, and he loves gentleness, and he gives due to gentleness what he does not give due to harshness. Now, some people may be sitting back and say, wait a minute, that's not what I heard in the news. Well, I'm here today to tell you what Islam is. Now, just because there are some people who do certain things, that does not necessarily mean that that's the religion of Islam. For example, you may find someone of a certain faith who goes out and does something wrong. Can we really say that that's a tenet of their faith? Not really. If there is someone who goes and does something that is just not acceptable in any society, can we really say that he's acting upon his religion? Not really. And likewise, there is Islam. So the character of the Muslim is gentle, it's kind, it's forbearing. Even in Islam, there is no compulsion in religion. So therefore, you've got a little bit of an idea what the character of a Muslim actually is.
Well, before my reversion to Islam, I was a teenager who, just like an ordinary teenager, who went around enjoying their life with wine, music, womanizing, and all things like that. So I was totally a very rich person. I have everything in life, but only thing I feel that I'm still insecure with what I have. Well, when I was sick in a hospital, when my wife, I was married to a born Muslim, and I was a born Muslim, but the only thing that we were not practicing Islam. So when my wife, my first wife, left me, I became sick, and I was sick in the hospital. So there came a Christian lady who just converted over to Islam for over 5 years. So I had to spell out my pain that I have in my heart, and I spell it out on her. And what she says is that what you have, your problem is just as small as this fingertip is. But the only thing that you doesn't have, the iman in you, that's why you feel it's a burden to you. So when I